There's only going to be so much that me and my family are going to keep fighting this thing. You know, it'd be a shame to look back and say, well, I've trained my butt off for 4 years, you know, with the goal of making the OA Olympic team and then stopping a year and a half short. Most people don't even know what a javelin is. It's underappreciated, to say the least. If some people would just take the time to realize the training and the amount of physical exertion that goes in to compete at a world-class level, I think people would have a better understanding. It's tough whenever ESPN, ESPN2, they're playing spelling bees and dog shows and stuff like that, and I find it hard to believe that they wouldn't want to put one of the most explosive dynamic events in track and field at least to show a couple throws. From the time that we're 3 and 4 years old, we're throwing something. USA Track and Field is gonna try to make a commitment to help some of the javelin throwers who are in need of financial help. There's guys who have potential to make the Olympic team and compete who won't be around in 2008 just because they didn't have enough, they didn't have money, or they didn't have the training situation where they could keep training.
Personally, the javelin in the United States, or the javelin, I should say, amongst track and field in this country is on the low side of the totem pole. There's not as many people active in it, unfortunately, because of the lack of opportunity.
It's next impossible to live on contracts alone.
If we had a sporting organization that could fund our throwers to the point where they don't have to worry so much about getting a part-time or full-time job, or going out and looking for sponsorships all the time and having the burden of doing that, we could be much more successful in the Olympics in Beijing in 2008, undoubtedly.
We've accepted it, and we've moved on. We're just trying to make money wherever we can.
When I moved to Georgia, I thought that I was putting in the final piece of the puzzle that I was missing, which was a part-time job that was allowing me to pay some bills but be flexible with my training schedule and give me off for time to go to Europe and competitions and stuff like that.
I came across Velocity Sports Performance. I knew that they had these great facilities, and if you work as a coach there, you get to teach athletic skills, which is what I wanted to do anyways. I like working at Velocity. We have a bunch of good kids that come through here. I like interacting with kids and just being around athletics in general. That's what I've known all my life. So I'd like to feel like I was able to give back some of that knowledge. For almost 5 months, I'll be going on basically two-a-days, working out twice a day for a couple hours each time. So it's kind of a vicious cycle. You gotta be able to rest, you gotta be able to train, but you also gotta have some kind of income. The ideal training environment for me right now would actually be somewhere like our Olympic Training Center in San Diego. A lot of the problems that I had this year were medical related and financially related, and those are two things that would be solved if I lived at the training center. You have access to world-class medical staff anytime that you need it. You get to live for free and you get to eat for free. Pretty much got everything that you need to compete. In order to get into the training center, you're required to have the International A standard. The International A standard varies for different events, but for my events, 81 meters, which if I'm healthy is not that bad of a problem. I just haven't been able to put it together yet. You have to be able to put yourself in an environment like the guys who you're competing against. You gotta be able to train like you're top 10 in the world to compete like you're top 10 in the world. Just as I started to turn, I felt a huge pop. You could hear it, and I certainly could feel it.
I just gotta keep, you know, looking on the bright side. I'm healthy. I needed about 10 more throws to get going. Starting to figure it out there at the end. My body was holding up. I just ran out of time. So it's gonna be interesting to see where I can get to go throw and who's gonna have me.
Got up to my training facility, Velocity Sports Performance. Yeah, the alarm code was going off, so I punch in my my four-digit alarm code, and the code stays on. I knew something was up. They had then proceeded to tell me that they had decided to close the facility. I lose not only my training facility, but my source of part-time income. And living check to check as is, that's a major problem. Lost my job and my training facility all in one day, so it was a pretty tough day.
It kind of puts things into high gear as far as I have to have a training center.
I got the competitive profile in my corner that's going to help, but it's always iffy when it comes down to other people's decisions. I've wanted to quit a couple hundred times. For me to just kind of throw it away and not give myself a shot at the next World Championships and Olympic Games would be a tremendous waste.
Kind of put all my eggs in one basket, and thankfully it panned out, and I've got a support structure now, which I haven't necessarily had since I started training. Well, right now the immediate goal is to get to the training center and get started, get ready for the 2007 World Championships in Osaka. And once that gets out of the way, then we'll move on to the next big picture, which is the overall goal, which is Beijing 2008, Games of the Olympics.
Okay.